I'm going to describe the interactive simulation that looks at the entropy change of mixing. And so what we're looking at is the case where we have two containers that have a divider separating them. So these are different gases. We can control the partial pressure of gas A, partial pressure of gas B, and then we can control the relative volume. So in this case, the volume of A is 1.5 times the volume of B. We've selected the option of removing the barrier, which means when I hit the play button in the simulation, this barrier would disappear, the gases would mix isothermally, and then the simulation would calculate the entropy change for A and the entropy change for B, and therefore the overall entropy change. Also would calculate the final partial pressures of each component. So the other option is to mix them when it says compress right. What that means is instead of removing the barrier, we're going to create an opening in the barrier and put a piston on the left side and push all the gas from the left side into the right side, again isothermally, and again calculate the entropy changes of each component. And so hopefully this gives a little better idea of where this entropy of mixing term comes from, because of the fact that when we mix, for example, two gases that are at the same pressure and the final volume is the sum of the two volumes for the remove barrier option, we have an equation for entropy of mixing. The entropy increases in that case. Depends on the option here whether entropy increases, decreases, or stays the same. So let's look at that interactive simulation. So here with the interactive simulation, I'm going to look at the case first where we remove this barrier, and let's make the pressure's the same on each side. When I hit play, then the barrier is removed. The entropy change is the same for each gas, assuming they have the same heat capacity. And each gas expands so that its pressure is half of what it was originally, and therefore it occupies larger volume. Or lower partial pressure means a larger entropy. If I reset, I can also, of course, look at the case where the volumes are not the same. And so this means I have a different amount of gas on each side if the pressure is the same, and therefore the entropy change is different for two reasons. One, notice that gas B went from pressure 0.5 to 0.2, and so it has the larger entropy change, even though there was more moles of A, but the pressure drop was less for A from 0.5 to 0.3. So we can change the initial pressure of each component as well as this volume ratio. We can reset, look at the case now where we're going to keep the barrier here, but essentially make an opening and push all the gas from the left side to the right side when we hit play. Let's do this where we have the same volume on each side. And so notice there's no entropy change for either gas. So we've mixed the gases, but their partial pressures remain the same. Because their partial pressure is the same before and after, and everything is at constant temperature, there's no entropy change. If I change the situation, for example, make the volume on the right much smaller, so I have much more of A, same pressures, and I mix the gases, so the partial pressure of A actually increases. I'm moving it in smaller volume. Its entropy therefore decreases. Whereas, again, the entropy of B, since its partial pressure hasn't changed, its entropy doesn't change. And so you can try various conditions to better understand where this entropy of mixing term really comes from. It relates to the change in the partial pressure.